Welcome to episode 182 of Clarity Compressed. I'm Paul J. Daly. I will be your host. And today we're going to talk about why you go wherever you're looking. And I got my motorcycle gear on to help me tell the story.
Let the good times roll.
This is Clarity Compressed.
Okay, I put this on just so it would look different in the thumbnail, but I'm going to take it off. Gloves. The things we do for a thumbnail. So I own actually three motorcycles. I didn't grow up riding. I decided to get into motorcycling later in life. A great friend of mine turned me onto these old cafe racer motorcycles, and that started my journey. So I have three motorcycles. One is a very, very old 1974 Honda CB360. It's very scary to ride, and actually I'm about to sell it because I don't like riding it, because when you get 60 miles an hour, you really question whether or not you're gonna make it home. The second bike is one that actually runs. It's a 2014 Honda CB1100. It's really a newer bike modeled after the older bikes, and this is the one that I have that actually runs all the time. It's the one I ride the most. And then there is my favorite bike, 1979 Honda CB750. It was really a breakthrough bike back in the day, and it was made in 1979. I was made in 1979, well, actually probably 1978, but I was born in 1979, and the bike is a lot like me. It's really, it's got a lot of personality. It breaks down all the time, but regardless, no matter whether someone's a Harley rider or a sport bike rider, whatever, you know, there's this big vendetta going on, but whatever type of motorcycle rider sees it, they're like, I kind of like that bike. So I really relate and connect to this bike, and this one never runs, which is why it's in the shop right now and it's hard to get them worked on. But I say all of that to talk about this principle that I was reminded of. And I learned this principle when I took the motorcycle training class. So you get together with people you don't know, you get, you know, these very underpowered bikes, and you actually do a riding class that, you know, teaches you things so you don't kill yourself. Here's the principle I learned. When you're riding a motorcycle and you're going around a turn, it's your tendency to look right in front of you. It's your tendency to keep your head on the ground. But the problem is, when you're turning the motorcycle, you might not understand how your angle and your velocity is affecting where you are inside the lane. So before you know it, you could be far outside the lane or heading outside the lane, and it'll be too late to correct. And tragedy, right? Motorcycle accidents, not good. So what they teach you to do is to look around the curve. So if the curve goes this way and you're traveling around, you don't look directly in front of you. You actually turn your head and you look at where you want to go around the curve. And guess what? Your body naturally follows it. And strangely enough, you end up following that apex, following exactly where you're looking. And I thought, wow, that's a business principle. That's a life principle, that you go where you're focused on. And if you're focused right in front of you, you're going to miss all the other stuff. And before you know it, you don't have any clarity. You don't have any perspective on where you are. And you could be off the road. You could be in a direction you don't want. Something could happen up front that you could have easily seen if you were looking in that direction, but you're not. You're looking down at the immediate. And what happens? Bad things. And so in life and business and relationships and entrepreneurship and all these things, really, it's important to question, where are you looking? And it is important to not look right in front of you, but look around the curve and let your motion follow that. We talk about clarity being perspective of where you are on the map. You know, this is where I'm at. You got to know that. But as soon as you know where you are and where you want to head, you need to be watching where you're going, where ahead you are actually moving toward. And I wore this shirt today to really push this point down, because the shirt says innovation is a choice. So if you didn't see that, innovation is a choice. It's something that I believe, that's why I put it on a shirt. And you have to choose to look around the bend. You have to choose to be willing to change and willing to take on the fact that, you know, something needs to be better. Something needs to be different. And then when you choose to focus on that, you become an innovator. It's not a magic ability. And so I just co-founded a new company with my friend Kyle. I'm going to talk about that more. It's called Contagious Auto. And if you check out the site, we'll probably have something up by the time this launches. But it's driven by the point that innovation is necessary to get better. And for us, you know, we love the auto industry. We believe there's a lot of passion and a lot of great things locked up in it that need to be released. And the public perception of the auto industry and all the great stories and the great people and the great philanthropists and business leaders and caring individuals and community members, they're in there, but they don't really know how to get the message out. They don't know how to develop an internal marketing team that gets it out. And we believe that if we innovate internal marketing team training and coaching, we believe if we innovate there by looking around the corner is where we see as a world where the auto industry is actually a place where people flock to work. They want to get in because it's such a great place because we enable them to let it out and get it out beyond the borders of the industry. So I digress a little bit, but back to innovation being a choice, back to you head wherever it is that you are focused on. So I think understanding where you spend your time mentally is a great place to start. What do you spend your time thinking of? What perspective do you have? Are you naturally fearful? My one-on-one business coach, David Meltzer, is helping me work through this idea of like, where do I lean? If I'm afraid of something, what do I have to do to realize, number one, that I'm focusing on the fear and not on the actual goal, identifying it, and then actually starting to move in the direction by looking and now focusing on the right thing. So think, where do you live? Where is your mentality focused? Do you wake up with a scarcity mentality? There's not enough. Do you wake up with a more than enough mentality? Again, I'm borrowing from Dave Meltzer here. More than enough, right? Because the more than enough people are generous, they're laid back, they get a lot done, they can focus on important things. If I can leave you with a mental picture, it's someone riding a motorcycle and looking straight over the handlebars. That's a disaster waiting to happen. And then think of someone riding a motorcycle that's actually looking out around the curve where they're heading and watching their bike follow a nice tight line around the curve. It's really a great metaphor for life and business. Where are you focusing today? Did you wake up groggy? Did you wake up tired? Did you wake up motivated? And even in your motivation, if you did wake up motivated, are you just focusing on like, I got to answer my DMs. I just have to check out what's going on in the news. What are you focusing on? Or are you looking around the corner saying like, that's where I want to go with my life. That's where the real meaning is. That's where if I invest my time, energy, money, focus, that's where the real value is. And spending your time looking around the corner and understanding the results of what's happening and understanding the results of like, am I looking down? What's that getting me? If I look there, what does that get me? So I hope that this gives you a little perspective from my motorcycle learnings and really where it's a life and death situation every time I get on that bike, right? So that's a little bit more important to focus on that. But I hope that gets you thinking in your life. Gets you thinking in terms of your life. Maybe not life and death situations right now, but boy, does it make a difference a few steps and a few miles down the road. Thank you so much for spending some time with me here today. May you look around the curve this week and may good things come to you as a result. As always, thanks for being here and I'll see you next week. We can-